Hey guys, here we go again. It's Adam Gussow with a little quick hit lesson on something that I'm going to call the big octave sound. I don't know if there's a hyphen in there anywhere. The big octave sound. And what I want to communicate to you, for those of you who love to wail on the harmonica, and let's say you haven't really investigated tongue blocking very much, or let's say when you do tongue blocking, you think about it as a way of getting a kind of tight, controlled sound. If you're any one of those people, then what I think what you need to do is kind of break your harp playing open. And especially, by the way, if you're somebody who's has a kind of contained small sound, then what I'm going to show you today is something that you really need and will transform the way you feel about the harmonica. In order to do this, you're going to need to invest in, if you don't already have a key of A harmonica, you're going to need a key of A. A C, I mean, everything I do today can be done on a C, but really you need the A for the big clattery kind of sound that I'm talking about here. And what it sounds like, well, it's a tongue-blocked sound primarily, and it's about getting a lot of air through the harp. It revolves mostly around the 1-4 draw and the 3-6 blow, with a little bit of 2-5 draw and some other things in there. So here's let me give you some basic moves. So we're going to rehearse the 1-4 draw. So what I'm doing there is my mouth is wide enough open to get 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I'm putting my tongue, the tip of my tongue, I'm touching it kind of lightly. I'm going straight forward to the harp and touching it lightly on that piece of wood between holes 2 and 3, again on an A harp. And the key thing here is don't force your tongue down so that it, don't force it to cover holes two and three. It just let it naturally fall on that piece of wood between 2 and 3. And what you'll find is that the air is going to go through the path of least resistance and it wants to go through 1 and 4. And so if I just draw on that, and then what I'm doing is I'm putting a little bit of vibrato on it. Now, you're going to find, as you start to do that, right away you're going to fill up with air. So one of the elements of this thing is really learning how to kind of get that air out. Now, just that little thing that I did there, what did I do? Maybe I should just start by playing the kind of stuff I'm talking about, and then you'll understand why you might want to do it. So that's sort of what I'm going to be working with, variations on that. Why don't we start at the very beginning? What did I do just to get to there? Started on the 2-draw, and I, of course, lip purse. So if I go really slow, now the interesting thing about what I'm doing is that it's actually, when you start to try to slow it down and explain it, it starts to disappear. In other words, many harmonica techniques you can slow down and take apart. When you slow this one down, it actually begins to fall apart. And that's what's interesting about it. So, and that's, if I could get you doing just that much, I have done good teaching this morning. So let's start with where we're ending up, which is the 3-6 blow. Can you do that? Again, you want your lips to be open between 3 and 6. So you might start with just a 3-4-5-6 blow. And if you've got your lips the right amount open, kind of elongated, right? Then you'll have 3-4-5-6. And then if you put your tongue straight forward, you'll have just 3 and 6 and nothing else. So that's where I'm going with that. And one of the reasons why it's important to end there is because of where you're starting and what you're doing when you get there, which is you're starting on a draw note, you go in 2 draw, you're kind of going into the 3 draw to the 1 4 draw octave, but then you kind of are reversing direction with a little bit of 2 5 blow and then a big powerful 3 6 blow. And that keeps draw and blow in balance, which is to say it keeps the amount of air that you're sucked in balance with the amount of air that you're blowing out. And that's crucial for this big sound. You can't just keep taking air in, right? So if you're a player who loves to wail on holes 2, 3, 4, maybe 5, maybe even 6, if you love to wail on those draw notes, but you're not somebody who plays the 3-6 blow and considers that a really powerful move, then this is something that'll get you going in that direction. So what am I doing there? Now all of this is lip pursed on 2. I'm going 2 draw. I'm broadening my lips to get a little 2, 3, 4 draw. Very quick. It's almost not even there. But if I'm slowing it down, it starts to show up there. So I'm going from 2 draw to 3 draw. And then, because my way of playing this stuff requires this, I go from a 2 draw and then 3 draw that are lip pursed to a 1-4 tongue block, which is to say I let the harp come forward and actually it may click against my teeth. Not everybody does that, but I sometimes do that on this. Yeah, right there I do. But you don't have to. If you keep enough tension with your lips and your tongue, you can kind of push things forward and not clack those cover plates against your teeth. But I like them against my teeth on this particular thing. Now, I went into it by sliding down. I call it chirping. I know other people do this, but I've never heard a good term for it. It's a glissando, a downward glissando onto the 2 draw. And it adds just a little bit of spice that really kind of makes this thing powerful. But I would not start there. I'm just telling you it's something to add eventually if you want to goose it up. If you try to start there, you'll distort everything else. So don't start there. The big octave sound, that's the name of this lesson. So I go from the 1-4 draw, 2 draw, 3 draw, then 1-4, to 2-5 blow. But it's really just a prelude to throw me in to the 3-6 blow. That's actually a nice way of making a little continuing thing out of this. Check this out. I'll do it a little bit softer. Now, coming back down, there I'm just blowing, blah, blah, I'm blowing. And then I'm going to 2-5 blow, 1-4 draw. And then the weakness of my sort of going from tongue blocking to lip pursing is that in those transition moments, sometimes it gets a little messy. And if I haven't practiced a lot, it sounds a little messy. So so that's the moment from, I'm going from 1-4 draw to bent 3 and then letting it out. I could do that. Okay, I think this lesson is about over because I think just that first What am I doing there? What am I doing there? So that's all, there's no tongue blocking there. I'm just taking a lip purse to draw. I'm going wa-da-da-da-da-da. So I'm doing. And there, all that makes that particular thing work is the fact that there's a sort of, the B section is slightly different from the A section. Which is that I'm getting that boom, ba-da-da. This isn't the big octave sound, but this is also really important stuff, isn't it? Sorry, this is a messy lesson, but at least I'm exposing you to some sounds. Oh, it's starting to rain. That tells me it's time to end the lesson. I'm starting to expose you to some sounds that you'll then have in your ears. Hopefully you'll be saying, how do I make those sounds? And then I will have done my job, which is to inspire and direct and say, this is something you could be working on. So if I put those kinds of things together, I didn't really do it right. I would go like this. That did not really jump, okay? And part of what this is about is listening, and listening for when something is really bouncing, is really swinging, and listen for when there are little things that... Wow, it's really raining here in Mississippi. Jesus, it is. We're having those May thunderstorms. Okay, we're done. I've wasted enough of your time. I'll be back at you at some point in the not-too-distant future with something different, something a little bit different, okay? The big octave sound this time around. This is Adam Gussow with Modern Blues Harmonica. Bye-bye. See you down the road.